Dual intentions. Good morning, coaches. Today I'm going to be talking about how we can use different intentions in our playing sessions and our session activities to create more realism for how we play. Typically in a given session, we have our general theme, and everyone is aware of kind of what we're working through. And when we add restrictions or conditions into our gameplay, for example, we're building out of the back, building to progress, and that first pass has to be short. If that pass is going to be short and everyone in the entire field knows that, it's going to change how the gameplay is organized, because red, for example, if they know that first ball has to be short, they don't necessarily have to commit defenders to the opposing attackers. So if we have our attackers playing short and we have our opposing team positioned like so, these players are going to be less likely to want to hold back because they know that the ball is not going to be played over. They know that they don't have to protect this space in the same way they would if blue was allowed to play long. So they can play in a slightly more unrealistic way. So using dual intentions, having one team given one condition, restriction, incentive, and the opposing team giving a different one, will change how each team is going to approach their task in a more realistic way. So rather than in this scenario, we have our 7v7, red is attacking big goal, blue is attacking the two small goals, and we've divided the field into four equal quadrants. We have the left, the right, and we have the defensive half and the attacking half, at least from blue's perspective. So we're gonna start our game and we're gonna play 7v7, no restrictions, no incentives, and we're just gonna play for a few minutes, and I'm gonna kind of watch and see how things develop. And then I'm gonna go to the blue team, which most likely is gonna be more defensive players. I'm gonna say, hey, for the next 10 minutes, when you play out, every time the ball goes out, it's gonna start back with the goalkeeper, and your first pass has to be into the defensive half. You can't play over, you can't play past the line. That's it, nothing else. Your first ball has to be short. Not gonna tell them anything about what red is gonna do. Then I'm gonna walk over to red and say, hey, your goal is to try to trap in the left quadrant. That's it, not gonna tell them what blue is having to do. They are gonna know that blue is gonna have to play on every restart with the goalkeeper, but they don't necessarily know it's going to be to the left or right or short. They don't know that first play has to be short. So they are gonna have to protect the downside a little bit. They're gonna have to protect this area a little bit because they know that blue might be able to play long. They don't know that restriction is in place. So with their intention, however, being able to trap in the left quadrant, ideally they're going to self-organize in a way that is going to encourage that first pass to go into this quadrant. Now, meanwhile, of course, gray knows they have to play short, but they don't know what red is going to have to do. They don't know that red is specifically intending to trap in the left quadrant. They have to play as if it is a real game, not knowing what the restrictions are. So by using dual intentions, and the dual there is ideal, with the two opposing views, each team is going to play with a specific intention that is going to be relevant to what they're working on. Blue trying to build out of the back, and red trying to press high and trap in that attacking third. But by not knowing what the other is specifically doing, gray doesn't know specifically exactly what red is trying to do, and red doesn't know exactly what gray is going to try to do, it can create for a more realistic gameplay scenario that we are likely to see on game day. Because we get to go to game day, we don't know exactly what the opposing team is trying to do. They might try to play short, they might try to play long. We don't know what their intention is. So how can we create opportunities for ourselves that are going to create more realistic gameplay scenarios that are gonna be relevant to what we do and as they transfer into the game on game day? Dual intentions.